So here we are in the gallery, and we're surrounded by these really beautiful and colourful paintings by Duncan Grant. And it's hard to imagine that in 1920, critics considered them to be defiant modernity, that they were on the cutting edge of the arts being made in Britain at that time. So Sir Claude Phillips, reviewing in the Daily Telegraph, said, "Mr. Duncan Grant, one of the most audacious, and it must be owned, one of the most brilliant of the post-impressionists, or extremists, or whatever may be the proper designation for artists of this school, has challenged the unhappy citizen to face a show of the most defiant modernity." Grant himself had had this sort of big sea change in his work and his ideas. In 1910, he'd seen Roger Fry's first post-impressionist exhibition, which brought over, for the first time to England en masse, works by Cézanne, Van Gogh and Gauguin. The young artists were totally inspired and were eager to sort of implement these artistic practices in their own work, and Duncan Grant was one of those people. So his work kind of changes in this very short period of time from doing very tight and detailed work into painting these wonderful, exuberant canvases that we see here. So these are 10 years later than the 1910 show, but it's still got the colours of post-impression, it's still got the energy, it's still got the slight abstracted forms and the painterly mark. It's got a theatricality about it. So this scene, he uses the curtains around the window, but they also become curtains to present a theatrical sort of scene to heighten the unreality of the painting. And paintings like Wash Handstand that we have on loan from America, where he's taken the very mundane objects that you would have used just on a daily basis for washing, the jug and the bowl and the soap and the wash hand stand, and really, really amped it up, really made it almost a hallucinogenic, psychedelic sort of composition, adding in all these different colours, accentuating the shapes and the lines, and making a kind of almost like a wonderland inside the canvas that sort of will attract the viewer in. 1920 was also a period of change. So there were also paintings in the show where he was sort of moving away from that earlier post-impressionist art into a kind of more neoclassical work. So if you look at Tightrope Walker and Juggler, you see a more solid forming of the limbs and the body. You see a dampening down of colour a bit. And there's an interesting use in some of the still lives, which some are quite loose and sort of quite rapidly painted, and then some are incredibly highly finished works like Clematis, where Duncan Grant has really rendered each leaf, each petal, each element of the composition to almost to the ultimate. You couldn't add any more paint to this painting. So Duncan Grant was on the cusp of a new decade and was really exploring all the different elements in his artistic practice. Slightly confusing critics, slightly confusing the audience, giving them a post-impressionist aesthetic that they were kind of used to, but still was very tantalizing and possibly shocking, but also showing his audience what was to come, what was he was going to be doing in the 1920s, this more solid, more rendered, more considered work.